So we are going to take a look at something very special today. It is a portable touchscreen monitor by ViewSonic, and while the intended use case for it is on the go with your devices like laptops and smartphones, I will show you how you can use this on your desktop PC to take your computer interaction to a totally next level. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and let's get started. Now, if you have watched my video on Asus ZenBook Duo, you would know how much I and other reviewers liked their dual screen touch layout, because the position of touchscreens on those laptops really turns them into a very versatile way of interacting with the apps on the laptop, and we have also seen Apple implementing a touch bar solution to their laptops to enhance their functionality. Now, that kind of interactivity is something that you can add to your desktop PC with the ViewSonic TD1655, and I think that it works even better on a desktop because of how big of a touch surface you can have with this. For people who just use their PCs casually or for gaming, you can do a lot of things like having your social media open on one tab while you do something else on your main monitor, or you can add something like a music player on the touchscreen monitor and then be able to quickly seek to different places on the tracks or change tracks with a single touch. The smaller size of the TD1655 actually makes it an excellent monitor for putting your secondary tasks on. You can even put shortcuts directly on the desktop screen, and these shortcuts can also be auto hotkey automations, so this can kind of act as a Stream Deck, but with much more customizability. Adjusting volume or your monitor brightness this way is quite easy, and having your taskbar on it also allows you to quickly open or switch to your favorite apps. But this gets to a totally next level if you use your PC for work, because if you create content, edit videos, or produce music, then the possibilities that you have with a device like this are just endless. The reason people like me use 3 monitors for video editing is that because in software like Premiere, there are just too many panels that you have to switch between, so having multiple monitors really helps. The really great thing about the TD1655 monitor is that you can drag panels from Premiere onto it, and then you can use your fingers to easily do things like color correction, because in panels like these, you have to drag these sliders or use the color wheels, so with a touchscreen next to your keyboard, you can really make it much easier to reach to those controls and adjust them quickly. Now, physical control surfaces for software like these are quite expensive, and there is no way to bind these adjustments to your keyboard, so even though this won't be as easy to use as something like a Tangent, Ripple or Wave, you can use it for other things besides Premiere too. The same goes for music production software like FL Studio, because these software also have too many panels to deal with, and there are lots of fader sliders, so you can, for example, drag faders on it and adjust them quickly like you would with physical faders. You can even put virtual instruments on the monitor and play them like a physical keyboard. The TD1655 also comes with a capacitive touch pen with replaceable tips, so in drawing apps like Adobe Photoshop, you can also drag different sections to the monitor, and because it is a touchscreen, you can even quickly draw something with a pen and drag it to the main monitor. Now, this isn't going to work as well as a Wacom tablet because it is a regular capacitive touchscreen, but the touchscreen actually detected all 10 of my fingers, and the touch in general works very well on this monitor. You can also use this as a touchpad for another monitor by making Windows think that the other non-touchscreen monitor is a touchscreen monitor. So for all kinds of creative applications, the possibilities are just endless, as I mentioned, and even for casual users, you can do a lot of things. This also works great if you don't have enough space on your desk for a second monitor, because you can just place this between your main monitor and your keyboard, and you can even use this as a camera monitor, as you can just plug that into its HDMI port. By the way, do give this video a thumbs up if you've been liking it so far, and you can also subscribe with bell so you don't miss out on future videos. Out of the box, the colors on the monitor look a bit desaturated, but that can be quickly fixed by changing its view mode to web. After that, everything looks nice. The specs mentioned on their website do mention that this only covers 64% of sRGB color space, which doesn't sound great, but in practice, I found the screen to look pretty good. 250 nits of brightness is also not super bright, but I never go even that high on my desktop monitors. Viewing angles on this are pretty good, and the 1080p resolution also looks sharp on its 15.6 inch screen. The screen has a glossy finish on it, which makes it look very clear, but just like your phone or tablet, this will attract fingerprints. The monitor has two USB-C ports on the side along with the mini HDMI port. If you use the HDMI port for display, you will have to provide power with the USB-C port, but if you use something that has power and display out from its USB port like my ROG Phone 3, you won't have to provide any additional power. The reason that it has two USB-C ports is that you can also charge your laptop from the monitor if you provide power to it with the supplied 60W power adapter or a power bank. The navigation on the OSD menu is handled by a single joystick at the back and it works really well. It also has speakers that sound like laptop speakers, so they do their job, but you can always use the 3.5mm audio jack on the side to plug in any headphones or earphones. You get a really nice magnetic cover in the box that will protect the screen from scratches, and the overall construction of this monitor feels very premium. It's actually so good that I really thought that this was made completely of metal, but only the support hinge is made of metal with a brushed metal texture, but that is actually good because otherwise this would have become too heavy to carry around. All the accessories that you need are also provided in the box, and you get a Type-C to Type-C cable with a 90 degree connector, a Type-A to Type-C cable, and an HDMI to mini HDMI cable. The price for this monitor is around 26,000 rupees, and in US it goes for around $330, which can feel kind of high for a small 1080p monitor like this, but it is a niche product that also has a touchscreen, and the feature set on it is very well thought out. The design, quality of construction, and functionality of this monitor is really great, and it is just a very well executed product overall, so I can see the price tag being justifiable. For people who want to use it with a laptop, I think that this is really amazing, but you will have to see whether you will actually be carrying this 1kg screen with you where you will go, because this will obviously add weight to your laptop bag, but you can also just keep this at your workplace if you don't want to carry it around. For using with smartphones, it is really cool, but I am not sure how many people will have a use case for something like this, but gaming on a bigger screen can actually be really cool as long as you don't mind the limited 60Hz refresh rate. For using with a desktop PC, I think that this can be surprisingly amazing and you can do a ton of stuff with it. For any professional use case like I mentioned in the video, I think that if you can integrate this with your workflow, it can be a pretty affordable way of adding some really cool functionality, and even for casual users who don't have the space for a big monitor on the side, this can be a really good secondary monitor. And you can also just take this with you whenever you have a need for a portable monitor. So let me know what you would use this monitor for in the comment section below. I'll have links to buy this in the video description. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell, follow me on socials. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.